Okay, here we're going to maximize the function c equals x plus y given the constraints that y has to be greater than or equal to 0, x has to be greater than or equal to 0, 4x plus 2y must be less than or equal to 8, and 2x minus y has to be less than or equal to 0. Notice the first two constraints, y greater than or equal to 0 and x greater than or equal to 0. That simply means that we're going to be, our feasible region is going to be in the first quadrant, quadrant 1. So we'll keep that in mind, and then I'm going to start graphing the inequalities 4x plus 2y less than or equal to 8, and 2x minus y less than or equal to 0. So I'm going to start off by making both of these into equations. So both of these are just going to be lines, and to graph these, I'm going to find the x and y intercepts of each. So to find the x intercept, we can simply let y equal 0. For the first equation, we'll be left with 4x equals 8. If we divide both sides by 4, we'll have x equals 2. For the second one, well, we'll have 2x equals 0. If we divide both sides by 2, we'll just get x equals 0. So this one's not going to be as useful because, well, we'll see in just a second. To find the y-intercept, we let x equal 0. And if we let x equal 0, we would have 2y equals 8. If we divide both sides by 2, we'll get y equals 4. Well, okay, back to what I was saying a second ago. If we let x equal 0, we'll have negative y equals 0, which tells us y equals 0. So here, we're getting a point 2 comma 0 and 0 comma 4 on our line. But for our second line, we're only getting the point 0, 0, and again, we're getting 0, 0. So what we can do, though, 2x minus y equals 0, we could always write that as 2x equals y. And then we can graph it just using slope-intercept form. Okay, so let's start graphing here. Again, we said we're in the first quadrant. So I'm going to make my graph so that we just really only see the first quadrant. Okay, so the first equation, 4x plus 2y equals 8, there's a point at 2 comma 0, and also at 0 comma 4. Again, since it was less than or equal to the original constraint, we can use a solid line. And then likewise, we have y equals 2x. So that's going to have a y-intercept of 0. And then we go up 2 over 1, up 2 over 1, etc. Okay, so now we simply have to determine the feasible region. So what I'm going to do is use a test point. Again, keeping in mind that this has to be in the first quadrant. So 4x plus 2y has to be less than or equal to 8. And our other inequality was 2x minus y less than or equal to 0. So for my line, 4x plus 2y equals 8, to test the inequality, I'm going to use a point not on that line, and I'm, again, just going to use the origin 0, 0. So, again, the other line does go through 0, 0, but you can almost forget about that line for a second. So, as long as I take a point off of the line 4x plus 2y equals 8, I can use that as a test point. So, for my first inequality, I'm going to test the point 0, 0. And certainly, if you plug in 0 for x and 0 for y, we would get that 0 is less than or equal to 8. So I know for my first inequality, I would have to shade below. For the second one, 2x minus y less than or equal to 0, well, now we can't use the test point 0, 0. So we have to use some other point. I don't know, how about the point 1, comma 0? So I'm going to test the point 1, comma 0. So if we plug 1 in for x and 0 in for y, I have to ask myself, does that satisfy our inequality? Well, we'll we have to say, is 2 less than or equal to 0? Certainly not. So for my second inequality, the test point was below it, which means we need to shade above it. And again, since we're trapped in the first quadrant, we know that our feasible region is going to be this little triangular region that's touching the y-axis. And it's easy to see that this is going to cross at the point 1, 2. So that's the benefit of having a nice, good graph. Okay, so we can even label all the corner points. We've got 1, 2. We've got 0, 0, the origin. And then we also have the point 0, 4. So now we simply need to take these three points, put them into the function that we were trying to maximize, and determine which of those gives us our largest value. So we've got c equals, we want to maximize c equals x plus y. And again, we've got the points 0, 0, 0, 4, and the other one was 1, 2. Well, the arithmetic here is pretty easy. I think, so clearly if you plug in 0, 0, we'll get that c equals 0, 0 plus 0. If we put in 0, 4, we'll get that c equals 0 plus 4, or we'll get the value of 4. And if we plug in 1, 2 into our function, we'll get 1 plus 2. Well, hey, that only gives us 3. So it says the maximum value possible will be the value of positive 4. And again, that's going to occur at the point 0, 4.